We start with an issue that David Seymour would no doubt prefer to be talking about, and that's why business has remained so grumpy since this Labor-led government took office. One of the latest business confidence surveys is from the Auckland Chamber of Commerce. Its CEO, Michael Barnett, says confidence, business confidence, is in freefall.
If I have a look in June of last year, I had 33% of businesses thinking that the economy would improve, 8% saying that it would deteriorate. This year in June, 44% of the survey respondents said that the economy over the next 3 to 6 months will deteriorate.
What is driving that? Is that just in a reaction to this government, political bias, that they don't like the government, therefore they're grumpy? Because some surveys show that the own activity of businesses isn't too bad.
And there is reasonably good activity out there in some sectors, but I think if you'd asked me that question at the beginning of the year, I would have said a little bit of a fixation, change of government, change of people, people need to get used to that. What can we do to make it work? I think the lack of decision-making in a number of areas is now starting to show up. So if you look at the construction sector and look at the pipeline of business that is not there at the moment, there's a number of projects in Auckland especially that could be undertaken, but they're not. So what's happened is that the workforce that was here in Auckland that were working on projects are now in Queensland. And if you have a look at the projects that are sitting waiting for government to respond, there's projects like Penlink, like Mill Road, like the East West. They're billions of dollars of work. The workforce has left, and even if they made a decision today, businesses know they're going to have to tool up and they're going to have to invest in talent.
So are you saying that while we might have some activity at the moment, the risk is in, what, 6 to 12 months' time that it drops away because businesses aren't investing, because of this confidence dip?
Because there isn't a pipeline of work, businesses aren't investing, and businesses need a pipeline of work. They need to have confidence. So I think that's one element of it. I think that there's a huge labour law change happening, and I don't think that the government has articulated it well. I think everybody expected the minimum wage to move, but the recent comments about, the $20 an hour, and if you can't cope, pick up your bag and leave sort of thing. It's that undermining of business and undermining of the value of business to the economy by some of the ministers. I don't think that's a good message to go down.
But they were elected. They've got a mandate. They seem certainly very determined when it comes to fair pay and changes to employment laws. Shouldn't business expect the pendulum to swing back a little bit? They've had it good for 9 years.
I do think that, businesses, so if you look at the 90-day, you look at the minimum wage, even organisations like the Chamber and others have said, look, we expected that, and it's come. But to turn around and look and say, and the next step is the $20 an hour, and if you can't hack the pace, perhaps you should get out of business. I think it's that type of comment. The move into Taranaki and the action around the oil showed a complete lack of understanding, a complete lack of process, and the commentary from some of the government ministers sent a signal that, we're ideologically driven, this is what we're going to do irrespective. I think everybody needs to stop and think. They may need to change direction, but we need to transition. Business needs to be given an opportunity to be able to transition into a new economy.
Do you think we could be in for a winter of discontent where we really see things drop away and a slowdown in the economy and a real mood of discontent?
I think the one other element that's sitting out there is the lack of availability of skills, and that's getting worse. So, if you couple the fact that the economy is struggling to grow and you look at the lack of decision making, I think it will perpetuate and you'll create an environment where the growth can't happen. You're going to have to rebuild for it. Will there be discontent? I think the longer we leave this black hole of decision making, the longer we don't get a little bit of action and motion into the things that need to happen, there's more likely to be discontent.